What lies ahead? Do we go for the secret, or do we find the... Go for the next one. I'll try a new one. Alright. This one might be hard. It's got 4 stars. Excuse me? Oh. Okay. Oh, it starts out. Wait, it starts out with this frame trick? Really? No, it does that. Okay. I thought they wanted that frame jump at the top. Like, come on, man. Oof, that's a stretch. What other kind of theme shows can we do? I'm on a roll here. I'm on a brainstorming roll. What are we got? Pinewood Derby show. That's definitely happening. I'm gonna pitch that to my bandmates tonight if they're not already in chat hanging out. Pinewood Derby show is for sure 100% happening. What other kind of theme? What would be fun to do at a show? I need some cool summer plans here. I'm trying to get some shows together. Outdoor. For adequate distancing. Rain gutter regatta? Yeah, it would. Yeah, it would. We've talked about, well, actually, that kind of is adjacent to an idea that we did have, which would be the Chess Cat's official boat regatta. That's true. Yeah, rain gutters would be all right. Maybe we could do something with it with ice. Maybe we could do some kind of like coat the rain gutter in ice and make like a little mini toboggan sled. You get like weighted little small like sleds with little weights on them and you slide them down. Like basically like bobsled, but just not. Ooh, cardboard canoe contest. I like where you're going with that. Yeah. I don't think a lot of folks would want to participate in that, but... Cardboard and packing tape, shit. You know, I'm thinking about this realistically, and I don't think I would be able to design a seaworthy vessel under these conditions. Let's go. Nice setup. That's classy. This is classy. Damn, that's got some goddamn class. Hell yeah. Mini golf would be fun. We could set up mini golf. I want to. Or just bocce ball or lawn. Lawn bowling or whatever. That's fun. We should do that this summer. Oh, give me a break me off a piece of that. I like that threat of having the two shells slide into each other and collide. This is a very clever hack. Like, this is just very cleverly made. There's a lot of really clever-ass setups here. Whoa. How long does it take for the average kaizo player to get good at shell hacks? I don't know, because I don't know what the average kaizo player looks like. I don't really know what the average skill level would be considered. I mean... It's relative to the time you put in. It's a specialized type of sub. It's a type of sub-discipline, in the same way that maybe Cape, Yoshi, other things could be considered sort of a sub-discipline of the tech. I gotta warm up a little bit. I'm not playing well yet. So I guess just like with any sub-discipline, it takes a lot of kind of specialized practice and study, but. The thing about shell is there really aren't that many different tricks. You just gotta get really good at the ones that there are, and then they use them in creative ways. I think Cape has more stuff you can do with Cape, as opposed to shells where you're kind of just kicking them around. I mean, that is what you're doing. So, like, don't know. I guess as long as you want to focus on it. I think for Shell especially, maybe less. Well, Cape does it in its own way. I think for Shell especially, it's good to have a prerequisite of being able to move and position the character really well. If you can be accurate to within half a block, a quarter of a block, you'll do way better with Shell. Shell, honestly, even though it doesn't really look like it, Shell is like platforming taken to a type of extreme. It's platforming but with no ground. Which I know is like, how can that be platforming? Like, it is. You're constantly controlling your jump trajectory, your boost height, your momentum. And so a really good understanding of how to do that on the ground already is very, very helpful for Shell. Do you have any amount of experience with the original game? I'm just asking. I'm not trying to grill you. Okay. Zero experience? I would amend that to be... Don't try to only play SMW the hardcore way. If you have zero experience, do everything. Do everything in the game. Don't try to limit yourself to no power-ups or anything. If you have zero experience with like Mario World, Kaizo, honestly, just play the vanilla game. Get used to all the stuff. Fly around with the cape. Right, use the fire flower, like all that stuff does come into play in Kaizo. The reason I suggest a challenge run is not really because like that's what I think you should do, but just that it's a good benchmark to show someone without experience about how tough Kaizo is. Right? The easiest Kaizo hacks out there are about as tough as beating the vanilla game like small only deathless 96 exit or something. It's about that hard. And that's really just, you know, just to give people an idea of the scope of it. Yeah. But the first and foremost most important thing to do is not even really to win or to absorb all the information about all the different tricks and glitches and things. Is just control the character. Just get so good at moving Mario around. Just be a freaking ninja. That's the number one thing. If you can do that really well, everything else happens from that. It's like getting in shape so you can learn martial arts, right? Like it's like literally like that same kind of thing. The more you can just move the damn plumber around the screen, jump and control your jumps and momentum and run, get P speed, bounce off things, land on edges, do really quick jumps. Heck, learn how to wall jump or, you know, try to get some, like, clip Switch Palace corner jumps or something. Do a yump. Practice that. Fundamentals. Fundamentals, fundamentals. All day. All day fundamental. God, in between. What's up, Dabble? Did I speedrun the original game first? A bit. I wouldn't really say... Yeah, I guess so. And yeah, that's all good. That's all good, yeah. Just thought Celeste.smc was the link. Sorry about that. I mean, back in high school, I knew the route that what we would now call 11 exit. I mean, I knew that route in high school, and I did it like sub 15, sub 16 in high school back in the day. And then I ran Mario World for high score, deathless high score on Twin Galaxies, which I maxed out and still have that record. But I didn't do what we would know as speedrunning with Mario World. I still have yet to like speedrun the vanilla game. Except for in the six. I do have an in the six run. I don't think I submitted the in the six to the leaderboard, but I did do it. Speedrunning the vanilla game doesn't really interest me very much. I I've played it too much. I did routing though for I kind of learned the route for all castles, no cape. There's a bajillion categories. If I were to run one, it would be all castles, no cape. In fact, I found like a 3-second time save in that route. So in theory, I know how to get the world record in that category, provided I just copy what the world record already did and then add my 3-second time save in. Instant world record. It's just that easy. Should be no problem. So, you know, since I could do that, you know, since I could do that anytime, because it's just, like, so easy, you know, that's why I haven't done it yet, you know? No, actually, it would be quite an effort. That's a great run. That would be a stupendous run with one little new minor time save that got added in. Oh, you're gonna get me with this, aren't you? Whoop! Shell. Oh, yeah, Calco, yeah, I mean, you're up against the likes of Louis, Calco, and people who, like, have always been running it. No, I have a lot of respect for the vanilla run. It's just, I would rather play Kaizo.